We hope you online will give us a little feedback, see if this new microphone works better for you. I'm glad that you're here this morning after canceling worship last Sunday. I miss seeing everybody, and glad that you could come today. Today we're having a sub-sale, and there are a handful of people busily working downstairs putting those subs together, so they're going to be very fresh for you. If you pre-ordered, they will be ready for you to pick up after worship, but they are also making some extras. So even if you did not pre-order, but you would like to pick up some sandwiches today as you leave worship, make your way downstairs to the basement and see if they have what you might want. Today is the Super Bowl of Caring. You're going to hear a bit more about that at the minute for mission. But we do have pots up front before you leave today. I hope that you might make a donation to the Super Bowl of Caring. This morning, you can vote for either, well, God taught me this morning, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers or the Kansas City Chiefs or advertisements, which are in the middle. That's where I put all my money, in the pot that says advertisements. Next Sunday is our annual meeting at the back of the church and out here in the vestibule. The annual reports are run off and ready for you to pick up. It would be very, very helpful if you have already read through this before we have the annual meeting next Sunday. I'm going to truncate worship so that we might have enough time for an annual meeting and me still get to my next church to preach. So it will be helpful if you will read this ahead of time. For those of you who are online, the packets are here at the church, and you could come by and pick up a hard copy any day, Monday through Friday, 9 to 1. So that's that information for you. We also have the 2021 directories for the church ready. They've been updated as best we can update them. And this always happens. As soon as you print them, there'll be a change next week that we don't know about right now. But those two are at the back and in the vestibule for you to pick one up and take home. And those of you online as well, come by the church and pick up your hard copy Monday through Friday, 9 to 1. For those of you who are joining us for worship online, today is a communion Sunday. So if you gather for yourselves some bread or crackers or anything to break for communion, and then some juice, some wine, even a glass of water will work. And you can join us as we join together for communion. I think that's all of the announcements. Pastoral concerns that I would share with you this morning. Lois Yerick had her knee surgery on the 3rd. She is home, as much as I know. She was to be discharged on Friday. So prayers for Lois, for her family who care for her as she's healing. And I would give you an update on my sister and ask you to continue to pray for her as she begins her cancer recovery program. She has seen the surgeon. She has elected to have a lumpectomy that is scheduled for March the 11th. She already knows that she will need to do chemo and radiation. She's trying to gear herself up for that. And she'll be pretty isolated through the whole process for trying to keep herself safe and not be around people. So continued prayers for my sister Frances would be welcome. Remember you are baptized and be thankful. Let's pass the peace with one another. Beginning like this. Peace be with you. And also with you. Oh, Bob, that's very creative. That's the first time I've seen this. This is the new song. Y'all are so great.
Coming up with what works for you. Please join me as we call ourselves to worship. Not yet. You're after the first hymn, Bob. All right? Here we go. The call to worship. With our whole hearts, let us give thanks to the Lord.
Gathered in God's sanctuary, in the company of the faithful, we praise God.
Our God does amazing and wonderful things every day.
We praise God for all our blessings, both great and small.
Super Bowl, and all the contributions will go to the Daily Bread, which feeds people all the time. And so you can either put your money in the pot for the Kansas City Chiefs or for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers or for the ads if you don't like football. And I'm glad to be up here because I want to deposit something in for the Kansas City Chiefs of all boys. I like the young quarterback.
Yeah, you can put it in. Yeah. We'll have a rivalry here, right in the sanctuary. Thank you, Bob. Bob sits on the mission committee.
Kansas City is AFL, Bob. Yeah.
Okay. Yep.
Yeah, Bonnie knows her football, it sounds like.
Oh, yeah.
It sounds like it. Thank you so much.
Yeah, you got to have a little noise.
Yeah. Well, I hope that next year the children will be able to walk among you once again, and we'll have a noisy Super Bowl collection. Okay. Please join me as we prepare to hear God's word. Eternal God, we bow before you in awe and wonder for the mighty and powerful works of your hands. We bring you praise and thanksgiving for your faithfulness to us, and for signs of your presence that surround us. We want to speak and live your word, and so we know we must pause to hear your word. So speak, Lord, for we are listening. In Christ we pray. Amen. with a different letter, and it was meant to help people memorize the psalm. The focus of Psalm 111 is on the wonderful works of God in creation and throughout history. The psalmist calls us to reverence and awe of God as we sing our praise. Listen for the word of God. Praise the Lord. I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart in the company of the upright in the congregation. Great are the works of the Lord, studied by all who delight in them. Full of honor and majesty is God's work, and God's righteousness endures forever. God has gained renown by his wonderful deeds, and the Lord is gracious and merciful. God provides food for those who fear him. God is ever mindful of his covenant. God has shown God's people the power of his works in giving them the heritage of the nations. The works of God's hands are faithful and just. All his precepts are trustworthy. They are established forever and ever to be performed with faithfulness and righteousness. God sent redemption to his people. God has commanded his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is God's name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All those who practice it have a good understanding. God's praise endures forever. This is the word of the Lord, the word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Anne Lamott says that in our relationship with God, life is a series of exclamations from help to thanks to wow to oh no. And we can swing between helplessness and gratitude, awe and disappointment on a daily basis. The book of Psalms knows all about this. So this morning we're going to talk about thanks and awe. In the early days of New England, it became a custom to put 5 grains of corn beside each plate on Thanksgiving Day. Those 5 grains of corn were to remind the people of the hardship of the first Plymouth settlement when the early colonists were in such drastic and difficult circumstances. In the midst of starvation, food supplies had been so low that only 5 grains of corn were rationed to an individual at a time. It wasn't much, but it helped them make it to the first harvest. When I first read about that practice years ago, we were raising 3 sons. Every Thanksgiving, I would put 5 kernels of corn on each plate. And before anyone could dig into the Thanksgiving feast on our table, I made them name 5 things they were thankful for. I'm not sure if they appreciated the exercise. I was in touch with them this past week, and all of them said, oh yeah, we remember that. But they always came up with 5 things to say that they were grateful for. I'm still not sure if they came up with those because they really had a grateful heart or they wanted to eat. One type of poetry in the Psalms is all out praise and thanksgiving. That's what Psalm 111 is. Life might not always be good. It might not always be easy. But when we engage in gratitude, we remember the evidence of God at work in our lives. later than expected. But in hindsight, Amy says that God's hand was at work in that time. You see, at the time, Debbie's health was not so good, Amy's mother. But she had not yet told Amy what was going on. During the time that the package was sidetracked is the time that Debbie told her what they were dealing with. So when the package finally arrived, it ended up that there were cards from members of the church. And those cards were saying that they were praying for her mother. Amy says she believes God held up that package so that her mom had time to tell Amy herself what was going on. Amy would have been very confused and concerned if the package had arrived in a timely fashion. Isn't God's timing amazing? God knows what we need even before we need it. Remember the song, Count Your Many Blessings and Then One by One. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. It's an oldie but goodie. In the Reformed tradition, John Calvin taught that everything in us should flow from gratitude for all that God has done for us. Without God, we would not have life, for even breath is a gift to us from God. Gratitude, Calvin says, gratitude is the correct response of the creature to the Creator. A while back, a friend gave me this book, 10,000 Things to Praise God For. He gave it to me the last time I saw him before he died. I want to share with you just a few of the ones listed in this book. The uniqueness of each person's laugh. Clean headlights. Life preservers. Finally being able to loosen your tie. I don't know about that one, but those men of you, men who are here who know about ties, that might relate to you. Giving thanks for sunsets, for ballet, for the illustrations in children's Bibles, for deep, restful sleep, for God's promises, for solar heating panels. I don't know how well those work on gray green days like we've been having. For hot beverages on cold days, yes. The list goes on and on and on. And I think this author must have lived his life out of a sense of gratitude. At the end of Psalm 111, we're told that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. The Hebrew word that was translated here as fear can also mean awe. And so it could read, the awe of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And so I have to ask, how wise are you? How in awe of God are you? Are you aware and alive to the reality of God at work in your life and in the world around you? In these upside-down days, we have much that we can complain about. I've been doing that on a pretty regular basis. But that is not the way. chance to watch those midweek videos. I think they're on Facebook. Yeah. A whole heart alleluia recognizes God's greatness and his kindness to his people. I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart in the company of the upright, in the congregation. May it be so for us this morning. May our hearts overflow with gratitude. Amen.
I would remind you that the words to the song that we use are printed in your bulletin, and we've heard it enough now. You might be familiar with it enough to sing along. I'm turned on. I'm not getting the messages. It's on.
Turn down your gaze upon the earth.
Gracious God, we give you thanks for the gift of life itself and for all the good gifts in our lives. You do wonderful things, both big and small. You do them every day in our lives. Draw near to us, Lord, as we draw near to you. With our whole heart, we sing your alleluia into the world. And pray that our lives will bear witness to your holy name. In Christ we pray. Amen. We prepare now to come to the table. We prepare to come to a feast that Christ welcomes us to. Whether we are gathered here in God's sanctuary or in separate homes online, we are all part of the body of Christ, connected with one another through him. And this is the feast set for God's people. Everyone is welcome here. Everyone is promised that here they will find food for their souls. We come to the table not because of who we are or what we might have accomplished in our lives. We come because of who Christ is and what Christ has accomplished for us in his life, death, and resurrection. So come, for all is ready. Join me in prayer. Faithful covenant God, all your world is full of honor and majesty. Your righteousness endures forever. We come together as your people and give thanks to you with our whole hearts. Creator of all that is, you have breathed life into us, filled our emptiness, and taught us your love. As we gather together in your name, we give thanks for your Son. And we pray that through him, you might teach us to listen, to open up our lives to share your love with others. We gather at your table this morning, Lord, either here in your sanctuary or scattered in our inner. individual homes, and we give thanks for the grace that is offered to us in bread and cup. In this bread, we are reminded of the spiritual food that you provide for our souls. In this cup, we are reminded of the new covenant we have in Christ Jesus. Help us to live as he taught us to live. While we might have many different cups this morning, your love is poured out to us from one cup of salvation. We pray, Lord, in the name of the one who came in peace to bring us peace, who protects us and keeps us in his care, and calls us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. On the night of his arrest, Jesus gathered in the upper room with his disciples. He took bread, ordinary bread, and he broke it, saying, "This is my body, broken for you. Do this and remember me." In the same manner, he took the cup and, giving thanks, he poured it out, telling his disciples, "This is a new covenant in my blood, poured out for the forgiveness of sins. Drink all of you of it. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes again." These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. If the elders would come forward. am the bread of life. Those who believe in me, though they die, yet shall they live. The bread of heaven. Jesus said, I am the vine and you are the branches. Cut off from me, you can do nothing. The cup of salvation. Let us pray. Gracious God, we give thanks that your bread has been broken and shared, that your cup has been poured and blessed. Now we pray that you will fill our lives with richness and meaning that only you can give us. Strengthen our faith so that we will know the living presence of Christ in our lives as we seek to follow him and serve in his name. In Christ we pray. Amen. When the disciples were gathered in that upper room with Jesus, they sang a song before they went out. Let us do the same. We are called as we follow Christ, carrying Christ's light out into the world. We are called to give our whole heart, hallelujah, to God. To live our lives in wonder and praise. To let gratitude flow from inside us. So, go out into the world. Know that you are loved. Know that you are held. Know that you are sent. In the name of mighty God, Father, Son,